I'm eating breakfast at the busy restaurant below my apartment. A lovely young woman just asked me if I could hurry up and finish my breakfast because her friend is coming in 15 minutes and they want to take my seat. So, I'll be here for the rest of the day. Hello, friends! Welcome back to another episode of Reddit Entitled People, where we get to hear stories about people who think that the world revolves around them, just like this woman right here. I hope you stay for all the stories today and subscribe for future videos. Some people were never taught that they can't have everything that they want in life. This story's titled, Old Woman Wanted My Service Dog. So, I went for a nice day out with my mother and boyfriend. This was last year. Anyway, so we were strolling about at some beautiful gardens and my partner went to the toilet. So some old lady who could barely walk approached me and my service dog. She started petting him, ignoring the fact that it said, "Do not touch working dog" on his harness. So she gets into conversation with me about my dog and she starts asking some weird ass questions like, "What do you feed him? How much? Does he toilet in the house? Does he chew up furniture?" etc. Stuff you would ask someone if you wanted to buy their dog. I only answered a few of her questions and told her what service he does for me. Anyway, at the end of the conversation, she goes, "I wish I had him. He would make an old woman like me so happy. Ever since I lost my father, I've been so lonely. Would you ever consider selling him to me?" In my head, I was like, "Hell no. I've been with this dog for 7 years and I love him with all my heart." I told her no. Boyfriend came out of the toilets and we walked off. I thought that was all. Nope. I see a post on the Facebook page of the place we were at and it said something like, "My mother and father went here yesterday and came across a beautiful dog. He's golden in color and personality. He's got pointed ears, kinda looks like a German Shepherd mix." The young woman rudely walked away from my mother before she had a chance to exchange details to buy the dog. My mother is offering money for the dog. She says she's fallen in love with the dog and can anyone help her please? So I saw that and I flipped. A woman was setting me up to be robbed of a creature that I love more than anything else in my life. I ended up reporting it to the police and the gardens. I still think about it to this day and I keep a close eye on my dog. This post is a great example of entitlement. I don't care what happens in your life, just don't let it affect mine. This story is titled, "Privileged Teacher Tells Me Her Social Life Is More Important Than My Dad's Incurable Cancer." Okay, so this happened earlier today, and I just keep replaying it over and over with all the things I wish I said to this entitled ass. Context: I decided to go to university to further my skills as a teacher. A big focus on this course is collaborative learning, and so, in my group, we have to do a presentation and activities for other students. This doesn't happen until next week. This one girl in my group has been slowly ostracizing herself with her attitude towards others, and only one person now spends time with her on the course. Think pseudo-liberal bitch, PLB for short, who actually has an incredibly expensive and private school education and knows literally nothing about the disenfranchised and struggling people of society, even though she claims she does. She's hashtag down with sweatshops while clinging to her designer handbag type. Anyway, we agreed to meet today to discuss what we're doing. I didn't get the chance to do the core reading to prep for it, for reasons which will soon become clear. PLB says, "I just think it's shocking that some people here did not prepare for this. I want this done by Tuesday at 9 PM, no exceptions. Laziness will not be tolerated." I responded, "I think it's judgmental of you to assume that I didn't do the reading because of laziness." She then says, "There are no other excuses, you clearly aren't invested." I then said to her, "Not that I need to justify myself to you, but for your information, I have a lot of family responsibilities, such as my dad, who I care for mostly as my mom is trying to keep a roof over my head, as he has incurable cancer. His immune system got pretty fucked during the treatment, and so, when he catches a cold, he's very sick. I had to take him to our out-of-hours doctor to see if it was bad enough for him to be hospitalized. Thankfully, he's okay but still needed plenty of care. Doctors gave him 3 to 5 years to live, and we're now at year 3. He was my priority all weekend, and that's why I couldn't prepare for this. I thought that would be fine as we still have over a week to sort this." PLB says, Well, it's not like he's actually dying right now, so you should have still gotten this done. I have a social life that I don't want to lose because of someone not pulling their weight. I just got up and left. I sent a message telling the group that I will still work on the presentation and not let them down, but I just needed time to cool off. Oh, how I wish I had said something to destroy her or murder her by words, but honestly, I was just too upset and flabbergasted that someone, a teacher, could be so unkind. Nothing says entitlement more than planning over someone's special day. This one's titled, My Sister Decided to Have Her Gender Reveal Party on the Day of My Wedding. This is a rant. She's known about her wedding date, Friday, October 13th, for about 8 months now. I found out this morning from my mom that sis has her find out the baby's sex, doctor's appointment at 9 a.m. on my wedding day. She wants my mom and me to accompany her, find out what it is, but keep it a secret, then plan a surprise gender reveal party for that night, on my wedding night. Granted, fiance and I are doing a courthouse wedding, so no big deal. We really just wanted both of our moms to come with us and be witnesses, then have a small cookout that night with our friends and family to celebrate. Now, sis wants me at the appointment. Mom said she'd take us out to a nice lunch after, then leave fiance and I so she could focus on sis and the party. Then, I'm supposed to plan some kind of gender reveal party for sister that night instead of my own post-wedding celebration. My wedding is a complete afterthought now, shoved aside in favor of the new baby. I'm fucking pissed. She could have changed her doctor's appointment easily to the day before or after. Could have planned the fucking party for the day after or even a week from the doctor's appointment, but nope. She has to have all the attention because of baby. So now, fiance and I are doing the courthouse wedding alone, with maybe just his mom as a witness, and throwing ourselves a private party with just our friends. I'm completely writing my sis and mom off. I'm over this shit. I'm always cast aside when it comes to family stuff because I don't have nor want kids, and I'm finally done. They've proven just how little they care about my life and accomplishments. And no, I will not be accompanying sis to the doctor. I will not be planning her fucking arbitrary attention whore of a party. And I will be getting married and enjoying my husband that day. End rant. Thank you for listening. Entitled people hate doing things that they don't have to do. This one's titled, When Entitled Cousin Tells My Mom to Shut the Fuck Up at My Grandma's 90th Birthday Party. Just a little backstory so y'all can understand the entitlement. My grandma had 3 kids, including my dad. My grandma then left my dad and aunts behind and had another kid, who's my half-uncle, with a different guy. I didn't really consider her to be my grandma until a few years ago, due to the fact that my side of the family has grown closer to her. My half-uncle's side of the family is extremely entitled and treat my side of the family like garbage, thus creating a huge division. But my side of the family and I decided that we'll put up with them for a couple of hours for grandma. Now here's the story. My grandma wanted pictures with all of her grandkids, about 10 of us, including me. As said in the title, my grandma is 90 years old, she can't stand up very long, and has to sit down every 5 to 10 minutes. So we're all standing with grandma, waiting on one grandkid, EC. I see EC storm up to the rest of us and say things like, just get the fucking picture. The person taking the picture is my other cousin, who's studying photography in college. My cousin tells EC that since she's in the back, she's not being seen in the picture and needed to move up to the front. EC said something like, I don't care, just take the fucking picture, and proceeds to stand up on her tiptoes to be seen. After only 5 seconds taking pictures, EC storms off, spitting lots of vulgarities. Mind y'all that there are many children at this party. After I got done taking pictures and actually being a decent grandchild instead of embarrassing my grandma in front of her family, boyfriend tells me that my mom is outside and she's pissed. I stormed outside and asked her what happened. This is in my mom's word of the dialogue. Mom said, EC, grandma wants a picture with all the grandkids and they're waiting on you. Can't you see I'm busy? She was literally watching a football game. My mom said, be an adult, EC, you need to go up there. EC is literally in her mid-30s with 2 to 3 kids. She says, shut the fuck up. I don't need to answer to you, and I don't care about grandma's stupid fucking pictures. My mom walked away from any more confrontation. After this argument is when I saw EC being a brat about the pictures. I already don't necessarily like that side of the family, and I'm my mother's protector. I am livid. I'm screaming vulgarities outside, and I stormed back inside, and I looked EC up and down with the dirtiest glare I've ever given someone. My side of the family and I decided that I need to calm down and ignore her for the rest of the night, which I did. But I saw her walking out the same time as me. I said, "Hey EC." EC turned around and looked at me. I said, "Fuck you," while I gave her the finger. "Tell my mom to shut the F up again, and I'll make you shut up permanently." EC was very shocked because I'm not one to tell somebody off. I'm a very quiet person around my family. If EC sees this, be very thankful that I didn't hear what you said to my mom right then and there when it happened. Oh, and fuck you. Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into this episode of Reddit Entitled People. If you want to submit your stories, join my Discord server. The link is in the description. I'm collecting stories for future episodes. If you aren't subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss a future video. See you guys in the next one.